sense. Hopped out the Benz like it's common sense. Put a monkey on my feet like it's common sense. Got gorillas in the streets like it's common sense. Stack the money heads up like it's second nature. Got a stay pulled up like it's second nature. Keep a chip in my hair like it's second nature. Big make me care like it's second nature.
In today's late season matchup, we have two teams who have victory on their minds. It's the Browns going up against the Steelers.
Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Cleveland Browns. So the D-line's going to spread out. Now the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he is leveled. Knocked down hard. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. Now Roethlisberger on first down. This is Bell on the dump off. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down near the 34-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Now a first down carry by Bell. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for, but this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
They need to get this to the 24 on third down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. get the first down and more inside the 20.
So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. Scrambling, not particularly a Roethlisberger strong suit, but he does get the job done there and gets a first. And the offense lining up first and 10. From the red zone now, here's Roethlisberger on first down. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Oh, a design run for their wideout. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. From the 4-yard line, it's first and goal now. Now they'll throw it with Roethlisberger. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. This is a crew, they've come out flat their last 2 games, both losses, but just judging by the energy level, they look different here early, and that touchdown shows how.
Yeah, it seems to me that that touchdown gets them off the treadmill. Because, you know, you've been on the treadmill. I've seen you work out. You go forever and ever, and it tells you you've gone somewhere, but you're really out here in the same spot. They've exchanged it for an escalator. Still got some hills to climb, but they can get there.
These are good analogies. I run outside sometimes, though. So, you know, get some fresh air, a little sun on your face.
A little wind in there.
Yeah, that's right. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down. It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1.
Leopard, back to the NFL. Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down.
4th and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On your own side of the field.
Own side of the field. But, boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're gritty today. I like it.
I'm feeling it.
And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up 2 scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves him with 3rd and just a couple.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Offense coming up, needing 2 yards on 3rd down. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
And we'll get our first update of the afternoon for the Meadowlands. And the Redskins there out to an early lead. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And now here's a carry heading left. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
So it is third down now, but less than a yard to go. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He loses 4, and it brings up 4.
And partner, in a lot of short yardage situations, you'll see the linebackers step up into the gaps, what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, to make sure they take away all spaces, all creases. That one worked really well for them.
Yeah, only needed a yard, instead went backwards. Now the Steelers offense gets ready to get back onto the field.
They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
Roethlisberger.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The number one overall pick, Myles Garrett. And it'll be a 2nd and long. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. Space to maneuver at the 40. And at a 42-yard line here and brought down there. Call it a gain of 13 yards on the play. And they're going to have a 3rd down. They go play action now. Roethlisberger out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And at a 42-yard line here and brought down there. They are, however, facing a 4th down situation. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. A busy final day for you coming up in the NFL. Final day of the year as well. 11 other games going on as we speak. And then coming up later this afternoon, 2 games each from the AFC West and NFC West all kicking off at the same time. Raiders, Chargers, Chiefs, Broncos, Cardinals, Seahawks, Niners, Rams.
Loving it.
And
loving
then
it.
That's it for the 2017 regular season. It'll be Happy New Year time. And Charles, you going to dust off Auld Lang Syne for us tonight?
Meet me at midnight, baby. You'll find out.
Hard pass. Yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards gets him back to where they started, but now third and 10.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. On play action, they'll throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
He gets it away, and I think they'll smartly play keep away here from Brown. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. Throw on first down to Roethlisberger. Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Rolling to his right. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He turned that into a nice game. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Partner, was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down. Easy.
Now Ben on third and long. Now the pressure comes, and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Emmanuel Ogba in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a good result there as that'll get out of bounds and pin him back at their 10-yard line. And now the Browns coming out on the field. Even though they might not find the number one seed next to their name come playoff time, there's not going to be very many teams, if any, entering the playoffs on the kind of run they're on. They're hot.
And I love that word, hot, because every team in the league wants to go into the playoffs on that uptick. Because a lot of the time, you serve notice to the rest of the league that, hey, we're the team you need to deal with. We're the team that's going to be a real problem for you. And if they can continue this streak, they could very well be that team and gain that confidence that they're seeking as they head to the playoffs.
And confidence, that's the word I would use from our meetings with them. They said we're playing our best football right now. It is showing. Detroit! Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
T.J. Watt in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
They'll look to throw here. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. T.J. Watt in there to sack him, and that is 10 for him now on the year. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. With it is Brown. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. They go play action here on first down. He's going deep for Brown. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by Travis Carey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week. Three interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
Fake. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. 1:52 left to play in this second quarter. Back to Heinz Field after this. The Browns on third down. Not good. 0-for-4 thus far. This is third and 8. Looking to throw. And a third down pass falls incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The Browns send out their punter now. He's been terrific so far. The kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play caller. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll be second and goal. Now they'll try the sweep with Bell. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. good to make it 14-0. Boswell on now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Browns offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. That's complete. It's Gordon. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Detroit! Detroit! Hudson, here we go.
Back to throw now on first down. Flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Jarvis Landry, the intended receiver, and now it's second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Back to throw now on second and 10. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. 23 yards on the play.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Back to throw here. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. The Browns on third down. A pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. This time it's third and 3. They'll set up to throw. He's got his man. That's Landry. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. And Gonzalez puts this one through. So no update from Larry after 17 weeks. Folks are saying, let's get on with the show. So we'll oblige as we get you set for the second half kickoff. This will be fielded at the 6. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. To throw now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. T.J. Watt in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Fighting him off. Now he'll let it go deep left sideline. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. On second down, here's Roethlisberger dancing to his left. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. And now it's third down. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot. But sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. This will be fielded at the 17. A terrific return there, 27 yards all told. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns offense heading back out to take possession. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. Now a handoff as they run outside. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. They'll set up a throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Gordon. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now they'll run on the
has him over.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So the D-line's going to spread out. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gordon. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
And Cameron Hayward's ability to take on blocks, hold the point of attack, and get upfield serves him very, very well. What a nice play there.
Yeah, he can take on blocks because he's built like a block. The Browns on 3rd down. It's been a problem, just 1 for 7 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll barrel his way into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A great effort there. Touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Browns are back within a score. So they're going to go for 2. He'll look to throw. And he's got it. So the try for 2 successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. To return, it's Cam Sutton. And he'll get to the 30-yard line before going out of bounds. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. Trucks through him.
Oh, man, right through him.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 12 yards that time at a Pittsburgh first. Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
And that's one of the few times they've been able to contain him. He's had a heck of a game, and maybe he's getting a little bit tired from how many times he's carried the ball. But I always think back to what all those old coaches say. The ball's not that heavy. Keep carrying it, kid.
On 2nd down, Roethlisberger. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he almost made it, but just short. Finally out of bounds, right down around the goal line. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 44 yards. A 3rd quarter score now from MetLife Stadium. And the Redskins have scored to swing back in front. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the 1. call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal. Second and goal from the one. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Boswell on now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Browns offense back onto the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Shift together here from the D-line. Now a handoff here to his running back. And it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Pickup of 10 yards, and that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
That was a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a 1st down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run, they got a good push by their guys up front, maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
So it'll be 1st down here after the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. Switch it up here and look to throw. Now he's flushed out left. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. A very solid gain of 27.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a 1st down.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be 2nd and about 1 yard to go for the first. And he'll give it here to his running back. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. The Browns on 3rd down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. Now they'll run it on the toss. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1. And the kick by Gonzalez is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. All right, so you needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted, but it's a necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you could really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a three and out.
And the Steelers sent to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll make it third down. Now Roethlisberger to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Fresh set of downs here. They'll give this to Bell running right. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves them with third and just a yard. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
I don't know about you, partner, but I'm rubbing my eyes after that play. Did we just see that runner not get yardage? A big-time play by the defense. It does happen occasionally, even against the best running backs who are having big days.
Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll go for it with Bell. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play. He got it stripped, but you can see the panic in his face from up here through the helmet. He was able to dive back on it.
A good bit of fortune for him, because oftentimes on a strip sack, when that ball is wrenched out of your grasp, it can go in any different direction. It can go way away from you. In this case, it didn't matter. He was able to get on it.
Pretty nice gain on the scramble. Gets him 12 yards.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. Hits his target, Hunter. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And the seemingly endless drive continues. Now Bell. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
This is where coaches have to have spent a lot of time going over situations with their players, because him getting tackled there is not the worst thing in the world. You're going to run more plays, right? Clock's going to go. But his thought process is getting into the end zone. It's counterintuitive for him to actually go down in this spot.
Yeah, but like you say, you don't want to get in the end zone too early here.
No, not at all, because you may leave an opening that could come back and get you.
Ball spotted at the four. It's second and goal. They'll run it with Bell. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. And give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. Every yard they gain, getting them better and better field position, and obviously a field goal makes this a 2-score contest. That's really all they need.
And that means for your play caller, he's not looking to the attack portion of his sheet, right? He's looking for, okay, what do we have that's going to keep us in a good spot? No lost yardage plays. Let's kick a field goal and go up 2 scores. If we score a touchdown, great. But that's not what you're really playing for.
So he got 3-1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. He needed 3. He got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. Kick is good. They're all through now, by the way, in the Meadowlands. And the Giants, they wind up winning that one. Another victory perhaps in the cards. They're looking as good as anybody as the playoffs draw near. After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. Short kick. One of the up mid will take it now. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back at the 46.
There's no downplaying that we all knew that this was a critical possession, and to get a return like that to start things off, that's the spark that they needed. That's the spark they were looking for.
And again, this time to the tailback. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.